This video will show how we make this respirator mask in two variants. There will be two leather patterns and two types of canisters, a more complex one and a really easy one. I am using a leather working pen to mark the pattern and an 18mm alpha cutter. The leather I am using is around 2.2–2.4mm thick. After preparing the parts, you should end up with something like this. All the metal parts are used for plumbing and you can find them online. The copper ones will be the easier way to go. For the holes, I am using a 1.5mm Wuta hollow punch and I am also using a metal compass to mark a line from the edge. For the buckles, you can either cut between the holes, like this, or by using a straight chisel. I've bought this set a while back and I have almost all the diameters needed. The brass parts that will go with the brown mask will need to have some material removed. I am using an expanding wheel with a 40 grit sandpaper. I will remove the hexagon parts and obtain a round shaped piece. The copper doesn't need anything besides some holes for the air. This is really easy to make even with an electric screwdriver or a drill. I am using an expanding wheel with 40 grit sandpaper. The brass fittings differ depending from where you buy them, but most likely they will have some sort of markings. You can clean them off with a Dremel or flex shaft. I am also trying to remove the material that was left over from the mold and casting process. To finish up, I am using a nylon fiber wheel for polishing. This will be quick and you will clean the piece and the sandpaper marks. The same for the copper one, or you can use some sandpaper or even leave it this way, it's your choice. For the holes we will need a steel center punch so we can make the hole where we want. The pattern shows where to punch the holes. I will use a 3.2mm drill for the screw holes and a 4.5mm one for the breathing holes. Also, a countersink to round up after drilling. The screws are 3mm solid brass hexagon dome nuts. Now for the countersink. This is not mandatory, but I like the effect you can obtain. While drilling the holes I got some scratches, so I will use the nylon polishing wheel again. This is also to round up after the countersink. I am using some copper patina. The one I found available online from the US is called Black Magic Patina. You will need to Google it because most suppliers do not ship this stuff internationally. You can also patina the brass nuts or any massive brass parts. After dipping the parts in the hot water, we also want to wipe them off with a paper towel. For an extra touch, I like to use some steel wool to remove some of the patina. A kitchen sponge would also work. To fix the parts in place, I am using some super glue gel. For the brass parts, we will need to attach the brass flanged back nut to the dome nuts. For the copper part, we will make some small cuts, like on this piece I am showing you. I am using a compass to mark a line so I know how deep I will go with the cut. I am using a jeweler saw, but you can use whatever method you like. You can even use a scissor for sheet metal. Using a plier, bend them outwards. We will need to install the eyelets as well. This is not mandatory, but if you can, do it. For the brass one, we will first have to stitch the leather circle and then we will precisely mark the place where the holes from the brass part will need to go. Just follow what I'm doing. Also keep the same orientation of the brass parts so you end up with a symmetrical mask. You will also want to fix the screws with something like this or super glue. I also like, if possible, to use an edge beveler for the straps. I am using an edge paint as finish, but burnishing would be even better. Yeah. This leather I'm using can be aged using some wax. We also have a more in-depth tutorial on our channel about how we age this type of leather. Stitching is quite easy and the masks are almost identical. The differences are mostly in attaching system. I call this stitching ribs. We will obtain horizontal lines on the front and X's on the back. This is just a simple two-needle stitch. Same for the brown one. The attachment straps will be different. Use a softer leather for the edge cover, something like 0.8-1.2 mm but with a soft consistency. this will be a one needle stitch. When doing the side stitches, try to get the knot on the back side by going diagonally with the needle after you made 3 loops. After that, burn the end. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoy, please subscribe and like our video.